r/AskReddit by Planet Reddit. What's the worst case of oversharing you've experienced on social media? Two active duty soldiers who are married to each other, with completely open Facebook pages, start airing their drama about cheating on each other, each admitting that they cheated on each other. How they are going duck each over in the divorce. Their CO was on their Facebook page. So was the garrison commander. Both got UCMJ action for adultery. But wait. It gets better. They were ordered to cease talking about the proceedings on social media. What do they both do? They go to social media. Continue to brag about cheating on each other and put their commander, garrison commander, and respective JAG lawyers on blast. They are both no longer in the army. And yes, they are divorced. It was truly epic. And they kept bitching about their punishment. And everything. They basically both started digging a hole and didn't ducking stop until they got to hell. They then bitched about how duck they are. I didn't know adultery was punishable in martial law. My uncle had a daughter that was born severely handicapped. She eventually passed away around 10 years old and he posted a photo to Facebook of a shopping cart filled with candy saying, "Can you tell I'm grieving? Dead daughter." I will never forget that hashtag. It was an accident, so I don't know if it counts, but a friend meant to post a question including some private details to her private pregnancy group. Instead, she posted it on her own timeline. She told everyone on her timeline she has lost her mucus plug and had her bloody show. Took her an hour to realize what she had done. I also know a girl who posts fully nude pics of her 2-year-old daughter on Instagram. Apparently her husband's family had spoken to her about it and she totally freaked out about it. Now she still posts the pics and videos but covers her, nipples included, with various stickers images, which I personally find even more awkward. A girl I know thought she was posting on her private pregnancy page. Rather, she let us all know she was pregnant with number 4 and couldn't believe what a mistake this was. How could she afford them? How could she stay sane? Luckily, my friend messaged her letting her know the post was public and she took it down ASAP. My half-sister. Every trashy detail of every trashy moment of her trashy life ends up on FB. Or it did before she blocked me for calling her on her bullshit. The final straw for me and my brother was when she posted, "Well, my mom wouldn't send me money. So I'm homeless and freezing to death." It was September in North Carolina. I slept with some dude for money and now I'm pregnant. My stepmother refused to send her money for drugs. She was homeless for stealing from her former roommates for drug money. She had also faked several pregnancies for drug money and sympathy. I can't say I'm sorry in the least that she blocked me before I could block her. I once knew this chick who was weirdly obsessed with her male cousin. Numerous posts a day about him. And when she went to stay with her aunt for a while, she posted play-by-play accounts of herself going through his underwear drawer. Lord have mercy. No. See. You've got your cousins. Then you've got your first cousins. Guy, whom I was FB friends with, and his GF, whom I wasn't, would start an argument IRL. Unfriend each other on Facebook. Then continue arguing via public status updates. It was annoying. Until I got sucked in like an episode of General Hospital. Then it was all I could do to keep up with the fight. Switching back and forth between profiles and getting pissed when one of them would stop responding for a few hours. Overall, it really wasn't that bad. But a set of twins I went to HS with got pregnant back to back. And they posted pics and doodads relentlessly. Multiple times a day. So about 6 months into the second twin's pregnancy, I commented on one of her pics, "Jesus Ashley, you've been pregnant for like 15 months, have the baby or don't." And was promptly blocked by them both. Their older sister, who I'm actually friends with, thought it was hilarious. Edit. So apparently back to back isn't clear. They got pregnant one after another. As in, the second announced her pregnancy about the same time the first gave birth. The sister's right. That is hilarious. A friend of a friend decided it would be appropriate to post about her 6-month-old son's erection. That's not something I ever needed to know about. A Facebook friend of mine posted pictures of her wedding and then the next day posted that her husband had walked in on her performing a blowjob on her neighbor. Her husband had kicked her and her 5-year-old daughter out, and did anyone have a place they could stay? These are the Jerry Springer people. My dad has a taped episode of Jerry Springer that he saved because all the people who were on that day were from our area and violated their parole to be there. Edit. At some point, the cheating wife's pissed off husband yells that she had been porking Gabe. Jerry has the most WTF look on his face and says porking Gabe. This was supposedly new to them because so far it had just been the one boyfriend. Later they bring out Gabe with flowers and a hastily tied on tie and pissed off husband tries to kill him. Then spends the rest of the show snarling at him in his chair. Credit card. Expiration. CVV on early Twitter. You mean that lady with the blue card? The one who later got her card replaced. And posted a pic of that one? I remember it being as text. Like they were trying to text their spouse but texted Twitter instead. Someone I used to work with posts a picture of her and her boyfriend every day on Instagram with some lovey-dovey caption at the bottom. And a count of how many days they've been together. Every month they celebrate their anniversary. When they broke up, she deleted every photo with both of them in it. Leaving about only 3 photos left on her account. She got a new boyfriend about a month later. And now she does the same thing with this new guy. And I swear to God, I think she's been reusing some of the old captions she made of the old BF. So IDKY. Maybe just because I'm up way too late. But this reminded me of the other mother from Coraline. How she makes the little doll look like the newest child etc. Hides the old children in the creepy closet. Edit for clarity. I have a friend whose dad is a hobby painter. He has a bunch of his own paintings of women hanging all over his house. He cycles through girlfriends pretty quickly and changes the hair color / eye color / physical attributes of all the women in the paintings to match those of his newest girlfriend every single time before she comes to his house for the first time. Pretty sure it might be part of the reason he cycles through so many girlfriends, but I don't have the balls to tell him. CTO of my company went through a bitter divorce. His wife was friends with a lot of people at work, so everyone was aware of everything she posted about him on Facebook. She stopped referring to him by name and instead called him all 3 inches 2 minutes. That's just cold. You can't blame a man for 3 inches when it's cold. A cousin who gave the entire world updates on the sex she and her husband had. In over the top. Pornographic detail. She was friends with her entire family on Facebook. From our grandmother to her children. She got super angry with me and lashed out when I suggested in a comment that she keep it to herself. I'm embarrassed to be related to her. Thank God she lives hundreds of miles from me and I never see her. Mom. I'm sexually active now. Get over it. She's mashing it. Some guy I worked with constantly posted about his and his wife's fights. Every little detail of what was said. And what happened after. I think he wanted us to sympathize with him, but he came off as an ass in most of the posts. Before I friended him on Facebook, he seemed pretty chill. But after reading those posts, which on some days came once an hour, I was worried that we'd get news that he murdered her and I started to avoid him at work. After I moved on to another job, I unfriended him. But a few years later, out of morbid curiosity, I went to check his profile and they were still married and had 2 more kids. This happened with a friend of mine. So mad at my husband. Getting a divorce. A few years and 2 more kids later. I knew this girl who would post a blow-by-blow of literally everything she did for the entire day. Down to how many times and when she used the toilet and what she did there. My cousin's ex-girlfriend made a post about how she gave birth to a moth because she went to pee and a moth flew out from between her legs. I was like, what the duck? She'll make an excellent mother. Editor, wow, my first silver. Thanks for rewarding my bad pun behavior. I'm encouraged. I was in the airport on my way home from another continent when I was scrolling through Facebook and read my aunt's post, not a message, but a Facebook status, about how my grandpa, who I was going home to stay with for a couple months, died that morning. Called my mom. Who had apparently asked all family members to wait 24h before posting anything on social media so that I could have been told in person. My whole family was livid at this aunt for a while. 3 years later, my uncle, a brother to my mom and this aunt, died unexpectedly in the middle of the night. His adult daughter happened to be traveling to their house that day from her out-of-town home. So her mom asked all family to refrain from posting anything on social media until the daughter arrived so that she could tell her in person, and also prevent her from driving while distraught. The aforementioned aunt decided to ignore this request again. And my poor cousin read about her dad's death in a Facebook post when she stopped for breakfast. I had a similar experience. The very second my grandfather, who was like another parent to me, passed in the hospital, my aunt posted a Facebook status about it. That was how I found out. I had just been to the hospital. She was 100 miles away. She must have already had the Facebook post ready to send as soon as she got word he died. Our relationship was already strained. And I haven't been able to forgive her. I will never understand why people do this. This is infuriating. Friend of a friend posted about her affair. Identified the person she had an affair with. When it happened. In what office in her place of employment. Went into detail about how she broke her fiancé's trust because his previous wife had an affair too. It was a clusterduck all the way around. Was this a shaming post that the boyfriend made her do as a requirement if they were to stay together? Now that I don't know. Would be interesting if that were the case. Not sure if oversharing. I once took a pic of my shower saying about to take a cold shower in this hot weather. Posted it on my story. Took the shower and didn't think of it anymore. About 1 hour later my friend texted me reflection. I took a look. In the reflection of the shower you could clearly see me sitting on the toilet. Naked. That stuff got 100 views by the time it was deleted. Good times. Edit. This was 3 years ago when I thought it was in fact cool to share this kind of stuff. Accidental oversharing. Still counts. Reminds me of the time my landlord asked me to text him a picture of the tub's faucet. I figured I'd take a shower too, so I got naked then snapped the picture. Sent it and got in. While I was scrubbing my hair I thought to myself. Faucets are reflective and cringed. I looked in the reflection of the faucet and sure enough the upper half of me exposed clearly. He never said anything lol. Cousin made a post about her boyfriend cheating on her. His mother denied it. He didn't deny it. 15 minutes later her sisters, her mother, her mother's boyfriend and about 6 of her mates were having a full-blown argument with him. His family and friends in a comment chain that I swear went into quadruple digits and lasted about 8 hours. It was an entertaining night. It's not nearly as exciting. But I'm watching this unfold on Facebook with a former high school classmate and his ex-fiancé. We are all in our mid to late 30s and it's embarrassing to see. A Facebook friend of mine posted that she was worried because her 15-year-old son's right hand had begun turning a strange brown-orange color. There were pictures. She'd made a doctor's appointment. She then explained it was because he was using his sister's tanning lotion. Only she didn't seem to realize the reason only his right hand was tan and not the rest of his body. So. She let all of Facebook know her son jacked off using tanning lotion. One little mistake and poor Timmy had to suffer his last 3 years of high school being called Cheeto Dong. Caught bronze-handed. Guy from my old school had to post a story of him taking his first shit of the year. Like are we talking the 1st of January or later? Because. Poor guy. I'm friends with this lady on Facebook who posts about 10 pictures a day of her son just existing and she has to document every detail. Last year when he was 3 he went through a phase where he would whip it out and pee anywhere on anything for months and every single time she had to post about it on Facebook. Once even followed by a picture of him sitting completely naked on his training potty with a little tiny star over his penis. He is going to hate her so much in the next couple of years. At least she had the decency to censor his penis. Some parents don't even do that. My alcoholic great aunt spilled coffee on herself and uploaded a picture of her burnt boob to drive home how painful the experience was. Slanesh liked that. I can really feel the dislike you have for your great aunt as you referred to her as an alcoholic and nothing about that story directly insinuates alcohol was used lmao. Edit. Rephrased my comment after receiving so many messages about the possibility that alcohol could have been involved. Yeah, bunch of nitpicking animals. I will never forget this post. Old restaurant co-worker. followed him because all of his life drama would go down on Facebook. People posting to his wall about how he stole a child's bike and ruined her birthday. His mom calling him out for drug relapses and stealing from her. All on Facebook. When he broke up with another old coworker, he took to Facebook. He wrote a wall of text calling her every name in the book. Talking about how he was going to miss her daughter. Then finished with something close to this. Good luck finding another guy willing to put up with your fish market smelling kitten. Lomfeo. I still follow an old coworker I worked with for maybe 4 months. Because his drama he posts is just why too good to quit. It's the best soap opera in the world. Good luck finding another guy willing to put up with your fish market smelling kitten. You/fishy Caitlin. Hum. My mom wrote a very long, very detailed blog post about my sister's miscarriage before most of the extended family even knew she was pregnant. Definitely strained their relationship. When my sister got pregnant again about a year later, my mom was the last to know. We now have a family rule that my mom can't blog about anyone else without permission. This is why I've given up telling my mother about things that are sensitive. You can tell her over and over not to tell anybody something and she's emailing her sisters 5 minutes later. The amount of times my mother-in-law begins a story with "I really shouldn't be telling you this. But. Then don't tell it. I. And then she sits there dying because she can't gossip. My uncle found out that my cousin, his daughter, and her husband were filming cuck porn and posting it online, so he posted a long, detailed status about the whole thing on Facebook asking for prayer. The entire extended family found out and no one sees her anymore. Edit. He found out because a friend of his saw one of her videos and told him. We have a very conservative family and they reacted like they found out she was sex offender or something. Facebook moms talking about her daughter's late period. Wasn't there a case a few years ago where a court ordered a mother to stop posting photos of her son without his permission? With this precedent, I'm sure more cases will come forward like this. After all, it can affect the kid's future and mental health. I saw a pretty prominent journalist posting about her young child's anxiety disorder. And how they were getting over it. Good for the kid. But perhaps that kid wouldn't want all this to be so public years later when they air on the internet. My mom and I went shopping for a wedding ring for my wife. She took a picture of the one I bought and posted on Facebook like instantly, so I had to do an impromptu proposal. Bro. What a dumbass. It's worse than that. She made her son's engagement all about her. Girl I went to high school with posted a picture of herself at the bikini waxing place with just a giant fountain drink cup covering her hoo-ha. This woman is a mother of three whose oldest son was a teenager and was also on Facebook. After reading some of the replies on this thread, I think she deserves a little credit for covering her genitals. A girl at my school wrote on Snapchat about how she pissed her own nipples and how they are infected and described the pus and stuff coming out. The aspiring professional pisser in me is trying not to cry. Pour one out for her nips. Kids. Oh god, no 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 no. Some girl posted her used pad on Facebook. And everyone was congratulating her. You. Why were people congratulating her? Well, she is not pregnant. Friend of mine died after ODing. His mom had access to his Facebook. And because she was convinced he was murdered. Posted pictures of his body in the morgue. I get that everyone deals with grief differently. But I've got those images burned into my mind. She ducking killed that baby. This absolutely breaks my heart. A leader of a political party in my country posted a dong pic on Instagram. My sister-in-law checks in at the spa and talks about how she's going to Brazil, getting waxed. My son was like 14 when he figured out what she meant and blocked her. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.